Video 4, Part 3. Let's take a closer look at Part 3. This part deals with natural gas purchases and deliveries to consumers. Your responses here should be based on your calendar month records. Line 1.0. Line 1 asks for the purchased gas received in your distribution service area. Your distribution service area is also known as Citygate. This line requires you to report both volume and cost. When you report volumes in this section, please include all gas your company purchased with the intent to sell and deliver to its customers. This can include gas from pipeline companies, marketers, brokers, producers, or other sources. It also includes company-owned gas withdrawn from storage. Do not include gas injected into storage in your Citygate volume. When you report cost in this section, report on the total cost of the natural gas volumes. This includes any and all taxes, demand charges, commodity costs, surcharges, and transportation charges your company paid or incurred. If you are a pipeline company, please do not report on line 1. EIA evaluates your Citygate data based on a derived price. That price is calculated by dividing the reported Citygate cost by the Citygate volume. You may receive questions about your Citygate data in terms of this derived price. Line 2.0. Line 2 asks for total operational send-out of gas owned and not owned that is intended to be delivered to consumers during the calendar month. You might know this as throughput. This represents all gas that was delivered into your service territory from the first to the last day of the report month. This includes both gas that is owned by your company and gas you are delivering for a third party. It should include any line losses and any gas consumed within your company operations. Your send-out should always be greater than or equal to the Citygate volume from line 1. Please include storage withdrawals and exclude storage injections in your send-out volumes. A word about send-out volumes. At most local distribution companies, you can get this information from an operational function within the organization. Typically, you do not get this information in accounting. If you can't get an operational number for send-out, let EIA staff know. We will be glad to help you find the right contact in your organization. Line 2.1. Line 2.1 is for reporting gas used in operation. This value is the sum of three pieces: space heat, distribution or compressor use, and line loss. Typically, the largest piece is line loss. This includes both known losses and unknown losses. Known losses include leaks, damage, accidents, migration, and blowdown. You will also need to provide an estimate for unknown losses. Estimating unknown losses is the hardest part of line 2.1. The easiest way to estimate your losses is to use your annual lost or unaccounted for percentage. This is known as LUOF or LOF. Simply apply your LUOF percentage to your monthly deliveries. That will give you your loss volume. It's usually between 0.25% and 2% of your total deliveries. Due to metering and billing corrections, monthly lost and unaccounted for values can vary greatly from month to month and can be quite large or quite small, so the annual percentage is usually preferable. Line 2.1 and Form EIA-176. Certain pieces of information you report on Line 2.1 will correspond to information you report on Form EIA-176, the annual report of natural and supplemental gas supply and disposition. Someone from your company completes the EIA-176 form every year. EIA-176 contains similar information to the EIA-857 form. The sum of the 12 monthly line loss volumes reported for line 2.1 in EIA-857 should be the same as the line loss volume you report on line 17 of the EIA-176 form. The numbers you use for space heat and distribution should match the volumes reported on EIA-176's lines 12.1 through 12.4. Part 3 Review. Let's go over what we learned. Line 1 of Part 3 asks for the purchased gas in your distribution service area. The volumes reported in this section should include all gas your company purchased to sell and deliver to its customers. The costs reported in this section should include the total costs. Pipeline companies should not fill out this section. Line 2.0 is where you report the volume of gas delivered into your service territory from the first through the last day of the month. And line 2.1 is where you report the volume of gas used in operations, including company use, and known and unknown losses. Now, let's move on to part 4.